This video demonstrates techniques to establish a permanent land surface datum, nearby reference marks, and a measuring point from which groundwater levels at a well are measured. The materials needed include keys, wrenches, or other tools to access the well, an engineer's ruler or measuring tape graduated in feet, tenths, and hundredths of feet, a field notebook and a writing implement, a groundwater site inventory GWSI system groundwater site schedule form, metal file and permanent marker, spray paint, hammer and cold chisel, survey monuments such as a nail, spike, or tablet, camera, protractor, calculator, or other tools to calculate angles and lengths, topographic map or rod, leveling instrument, leveling note sheets, and differential GPS. Step 1. Establish land surface datum. The land surface datum at a well is a fixed reference mark located at or near the land surface that can be used to measure the altitude of the land surface datum as well as the distance from the land surface datum to the measuring point. Locate a stable, permanent location near the well to establish the land surface datum. The land surface datum should be in a location that can be clearly defined, clearly marked, and easily located. Additionally, the land surface datum should be close enough to the well to facilitate measuring from it to the measuring point, and it should be accessible to a survey rod or GPS antenna. Step 2. Mark the land surface datum using a survey monument, brass marker, or chiseled mark in the concrete pad at the base of the surface casing. Step 3. Take a photograph of the land surface datum and document the description in the field notebook. If the landowner does not allow marking of the well, then describe the land surface datum as accurately as possible. Step 4. The altitude of the land surface datum must be determined for each site. Locate the well following the instructions in GWPD5. At a minimum, the altitude can be estimated from a topographic map. Depending upon the use of the measurements from the well, it may be preferable to determine the altitude of the land surface datum using differential leveling or differential GPS techniques. Document the measurements in the GWSI groundwater site schedule. Step 5. Establish the measuring point. The measuring point is a permanent, stable, clearly defined and marked reference point used to measure the water level in a well. It is often located at the top of the casing in an observation well or at an access point at a production well. To establish a measuring point for a well, choose a point on the casing where a leveling rod could be set directly on it and a measuring tape can hang freely into the well when it is in contact with the measuring point. If the casing does not have a horizontal rim, it is preferable to establish the measuring point on the high or low side of the rim. Step 6. Using a file, lightly mark the measuring point on the well casing. Optionally, mark the measuring point by a permanent marker or spray paint. Step 7. Take a photograph of the measuring point and document the description in the field notebook. If the measuring point cannot be marked directly on the casing, clearly define it in the field notes. Step 8. Measuring point correction length. Depending on the use and storage of measurements from the well, the altitude of the measuring point of a well with a vertical stickup may be surveyed from a geodetic benchmark using differential leveling or differential GPS techniques. The measuring point correction length is the distance the measuring tape travels from the measuring point to the plane of the land surface datum. If the measuring point is above the land surface datum, the measuring point correction is a positive number. If the measuring point is below the land surface datum, the measuring point correction is a negative number. Simple vertical well. Measure the measuring point correction length in feet above or below the land surface datum directly with a steel tape or by differential leveling if the objectives of the measurement require a precise altitude. More complicated non-vertical well. If the well stickup does not allow the water level tape to hang vertically from the measuring point through the plane of the land surface datum, the measuring point correction cannot be measured directly. Instead, the length along the measurement path between the measuring point and the land surface datum must be computed using geometry. the resulting measuring point correction length will be greater than the vertical distance between the land surface datum and the measuring point. Step 9. Document any calculations to determine the measuring point correction length in the field notebook. Document the measurements in the GWSI groundwater site schedule. Step 10. Establish additional reference marks. A reference mark is a nearby datum established by a permanent marker that is used to periodically check the measuring point and/or land surface datum, or to reestablish the measuring point or land surface datum should the original be destroyed or changed. Establish at least one clearly marked reference mark near the well, such as a benchmark, a lag bolt set in a telephone pole, a spike in a mature tree, a mark on a permanent structure, or a poured concrete post. More than one reference mark is preferable. Locate a reference mark a distance away from the well to assure that circumstances that damage the well do not also damage the reference mark. Take photographs and record a description of the site reference marks in the field notebook. Step 11. Establish the vertical relation between the measuring point and reference marks by differential leveling. Document the vertical relation between the measuring point and reference marks. At each subsequent site visit, visually inspect the measuring point, land surface datum, and reference marks. Document any damage and recheck the vertical relation if damage is noted. If no damage is apparent, the vertical relation between the measuring point and reference marks should be confirmed at 3 to 5 year intervals. Accuracy. Keep in mind the following accuracy limitations of this method. The accuracy of the measuring point, reference mark, and land surface datum altitude depends upon the measurement method used. The accuracy of the measurement point correction length depends upon the configuration of the measuring point with respect to the land surface datum, angle of deviation from vertical, the ability of the hydrographer to determine the tape path, and the measurement method used.